Today is the day, and Traktor announced its newest version, Traktor Pro 4, with stamps built into it. In this video, I'll show you how it looks like, how to create stamps in Traktor, and of course, compare the quality. Quick disclaimer here is that I've been playing with Traktor Pro 4 release candidate version for a few weeks now, by the time you see this video. So expect bug fixes and improvements going on. First of all, Traktor decided on a prepared stamps approach. Though previously on their roadmap, they mentioned it was going to be real time. It's fine by me, since stamps that are prepared upfront usually provide better quality. Or do they? We'll talk about quality a bit later. In order to create stamps for the track, just right-click on the track in the browser and click Generate Stamps. You'll see the progress bar appearing at the bottom, similar to how it looks like when you analyze bitgrids and BPMs. Once done, the link icon will appear next to the track and you'll be able to load this track into the deck as usual. There is a new setting to set your preferred method of loading track into the deck, if it has stamps already created. Once loaded, just play with the track as you would usually do. All the metadata, hotkeys, BPMs, etc. is synced between the original and the stamps version of the track. In fact, regular users won't even know that Traktor created a whole separate track and placed it into the music folder on your computer. You can change the stamps file's location in the preferences, by the way. Upon my investigation, these files are almost identical to the ones you may create with programs like Neo Stamps 3 or Native Instruments Stamp Creator, the only difference being that metadata is a bit different to support Traktor Pro 4. So, in case it's necessary or you do want to do so, you can load stamps tracks created in Traktor Pro 4 into Traktor Pro 3. Though you'll need to know the tricky naming that Traktor utilizes to name these files. Also, Traktor finally added the UI element to display whether a particular stamp is on or off. Yeah! Let's come back to the real-time part of the roadmap. The Traktor Pro 4 version that I got to play around is far from real-time. In fact, it doesn't utilize GPU neither on Apple Silicon nor on NVIDIA-enabled computers. While relying only on the CPU to process stamps, it takes about 3 out of 8 cores on my M1 MacBook Air to process stamps and takes a lot of time to process them. Here is a time comparison of processing the same track using Traktor Pro 4 and no stamps. On the bright side, Traktor team mentions that the process runs on a separate thread, therefore you will not experience any crashes. And this brings us to the topic of quality. This time I did both scientific as well as back and forth listening experience comparisons. Scientific will be in this video, and you can check out the back and forth listening experience video in the description. I'll be posting that one at the same time as this video. So the scientific approach is to define the SDR metric, which is commonly used within the music separation software comparisons. For example, in Music Demixing Challenge in 2023, held by AI Crowd. You can read more about SDR in the description. I used one of the websites that validates this metric. You can read more about what I did in the description, but here are the results of the software that I did have time to test. As you can see, for drums, Traktor performs worse than Neo Stamps, but better than its competition, Algorithm DJ Pro, Virtual DJ, Serato, and Rekordbox. Just for reference, I also added few other softwares. For bass stamp, the situation is almost the same. Traktor beats the competition, but falls behind the Neo Stamps. The other stamp is the most challenging for all the programs. And that's what Traktor again falls behind Neo Stamps. But in this case, Algorithm DJ Pro also comes on top. Virtual DJ, Serato, and Rekordbox all have worse results. Finally, the vocal stamp. That's where Traktor seems to perform the worst. Neo Stamps, Algorithm DJ Pro, and Virtual DJ all produce higher SDR scores. Serato and Rekordbox come short of Traktor. And here is the final table of all the results. You can see that Traktor Pro 4 consistently outperforms Serato and Rekordbox. Virtual DJ is better only on vocals, and Algorithm DJ Pro is better on vocals and other stems. No Stamps and Logic Pro are better than Traktor for all the stems. Also, here are the highlights of the best and worst performer for each stem. To wrap it all up, Take the SDR metric with a grain of salt and always trust your ears. Because better SDR doesn't always mean better quality. However, those very much correlate, meaning the higher SDR usually means a better perceived quality by human ears. By the way, current state-of-the-art quality belongs to the TikTok guys and their CapCut and Ripple iOS apps. In my opinion, Traktor team did a pretty good job in delivering quality stems to their users. Yeah, it has its flaws, but the user experience is straightforward and it's definitely a step in the right direction.